in to another episode of Tribe Talk presented by the Tribe Club. I'm your host, Andrew Phillips, and today we're joined by Caroline Casey, who is the starting goalkeeper for the women's soccer team, who is off to a terrific start, 4-1-1 overall, and are at home this weekend at Martin Family Stadium for a pair of matches on Friday against Old Dominion, and then on Sunday against Harvard. Caroline, thanks for being here. Really great start to your guys' season. Talk a little bit about your performance and goal, but also just the team overall. It's a really good start.
Yeah, I think this year has definitely been different. The senior class, we spent a lot of time in the spring talking about changing the culture and really emphasizing one tribe, one family, and so just focus on bringing the freshmen in, making them feel welcome, and I think starting with that, it's just helped the team so much to connect, and I think that's part of the reason why we've gotten the results we have. I think our defense has looked really, really strong. The back four has been amazing, and I think that's why people are crediting things to me. But I think as a team, we're just collectively playing in the unit, and I think that's made the difference.
Awesome. Well, we'll get back to talking on the field a little bit, but some personal accolades for you. You were named a candidate for the Senior Class Award, which is a national honor. Just talk about what that means to you and some of the things that have helped you get there.
I think being nominated for Senior Class was really exciting, especially since the last person to be nominated for that was Mallory Schaefer, and I looked up to her when I came in as a freshman, and kept telling everyone I wanted to be Mallory. So for me to be nominated for this is really exciting.
Cool. So one of the things that probably helped you the most is you went on a medical relief trip to Nicaragua in the winter of last year. Tell us a little bit about that, how that experience was, and how awesome that was.
It was an amazing experience. I'd never been to a third world country on a service trip, so it was an amazing experience. It really immersed you in the culture. And as a pre-med student, I learned so much from the doctors there. We took part in the examination. We would do physical history, we would do various tests, and we got to practice the diagnosing process, which was really interesting to learn because you're not gonna get that in a classroom in undergrad, so I think that was an amazing experience. And I went with a bunch of people from William & Mary that I'd never met before, so I think it was really great to be with a different group of people.
And that's not the only thing you do in terms of stuff in the community. You do a lot of stuff here in the Williamsburg area. Tell us a little bit about that. I know you're involved with Relay for Life, also some alternative spring break stuff. So what's that, and elaborate on that a little bit.
Yeah, so my freshman year, I went to the Relay for Life on campus with my teammate Ashley Booth. And when we went, it was an amazing event. And so my sophomore year, as soon as I got here, that was the club that I wanted to join. And I've been on committee ever since then. We put an event on in the spring. You stay up all night. You walk to different events, raise money, which for the American Cancer Society, which is great stuff. And for my branch-out trip on spring break, we went to Richmond. I did it my sophomore year, and then I led the trip my junior year. We go and we help at the Center for Aging in downtown Richmond. We go to various different centers during the day, and we help out with different activities with older adults that are suffering from memory loss or dealing with emotional stuff from isolation from their family members. So it was really interesting from a social perspective to get involved with that.
That's awesome. Where do you find all the time of the day? You're also a very good student, a provost award winner multiple times. Where do you find time in your day to fit in community service, and let alone a busy soccer schedule?
It takes a lot of planning. I'm a planner, so when there's time, I try to use it. I don't like having downtime, but I mean, you have to be organized for people to handle it.
And then finally, the last part of the Senior Class Award is play on the field, and you've had a tremendous career about halfway through your senior season, which is kind of tough to believe. It seemed like it just started yesterday in the season. But you're moving up the record books here. You're fourth in career saves and closing in on the top five in shutouts. I'm sure you haven't thought a lot about this, but reflect a little bit on your time here at William & Mary.
I've started to think about it now that it's like senior year and it's the last time for a lot of things that are happening. But I think being able to play starting freshman year has given me a lot of experience, and being given the responsibility of being captain this past year and this year has really forced me to look at the bigger picture as a player, and I think that's really helped my game just from a mental perspective, and I think it's just been a long ride, but a really great ride.
All right, before we wrap up our show every week here on Tribe Talk, we like to do the Fast Five. Caroline, so here are five quick questions to let the Tribe fans know a little bit more about yourself. Who's your favorite band or musical artist?
Really like Dave Matthews. My whole family really into it.
That's great. That's my favorite band. Favorite food?
I love grapes.
A lot of fruit lovers here at William & Mary, which is interesting. Who's your biggest inspiration?
My babysitter from when I was younger, Alice Willard.
Cool. And then who's your funniest teammate?
Arendelle Miguelis. She's hilarious.
Squish, the freshman.
Yeah.
Moving up at the funny ranks quick. And then finally, it's a fun fact about yourself.
I have no social media. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. I have email, that's it.
Have you ever thought about jumping on?
I did. I got an Instagram for a week and I really liked it, and I liked it too much I had to delete it.
All right. Well, Caroline, I really appreciate you stopping by today, and as you can tell, a very, very busy schedule. Thanks for working us in. The Tribe Women's Soccer Team is back in action this weekend right here in Williamsburg. They play Old Dominion on Friday night, and they play Harvard on Sunday. Both of those matches available for free and in HD on tribeathletics.com. Don't forget, a live Tribe Sports Today will be on Periscope on Friday afternoon around noon. And stay tuned for all of the home events coming up this weekend here in Williamsburg. We'll see you next week.